Welcome, beautiful souls. Today I would like to share with you some more information about the Cygnus Wars that took place many years ago, but also related to the Lyra Constellation and then to the Mu continent here on Earth, because there's a relation. And this is because all of this information that I would like to share with you, it arrived to me through many different healing sessions that took place through different clients a few years ago, 2-3 years ago, more or less. And also part of it came to me through a galactic astrology reading. But mainly, the most part of the information, I perceive, I saw it through different healing sessions of different clients. So let's begin. After the Cygnus Wars, around 2 billion of years ago, more or less, a group of Cygnus humanoids, that part of them were descendants of the Patal race, went to Lyra as refugees, because in reality their real intention was to infiltrate in the already established, well-established Tal society that also was seeded by the same race, the Patal, because keep in mind one thing. The Patal are a humanoid seeder race. It means that they like, or they feel called, we can say, to seed humanoid people in new galaxies, or in particular in this galaxy. So they, for one hand, seeded or created a humanoid race in the Cygnus constellation, that and also they created another humanoid race in the Lyra constellation. But in Cygnus, not only created a new race, humanoid race, but even part of them, the Patal, the original Cedar race, established there in the same planet as a way to supervise their genetic experiment, as a way, to live, be part of their own genetic experiment. So, after the Cygnus Wars, part of this group, of the Patal group, that in reality worked together with the reptilians, or we can say they were allied with the reptilians, they went to Lyra as a refugees. They were welcomed there as refugees and established a small colony within the Tal society. The Tal society at that moment was in the star system within the Lyra constellation, in the star system known as Kepler 62. So they were there. This group of refugees came there, established, but in reality their real intention was to infiltrate in the Tal society and disturb it, instigate controversy among them, arrogance, it wasn't difficult in this case, and to promote separation and more ego, because it was a society that at that moment was very proud of themselves. They had a big ego, we can say. So they were able even to infiltrate among the Tal monarchy, the royal monarchy, because at that moment the royal monarchy of the Tal in Lyra was a very big family. The king and queen had many sons and daughters. Also, the king and queen had at the same time many brothers and sisters. So it was a big, big family. The refugees got infiltrated into the monarchy, and few of them reached the queen, because they at the beginning wanted to know the personalities, the weakness of the different monarchy people, until they realized that the queen in reality was a person with a thirst of power, with greed, that she always wanted more power for herself. So she was the goal to arrive, to reach her, and began to work her, work her personality, until the queen began to worship secretly the god, the entity, we can say, better said. I don't like the name god or goddess either. So she began to worship the entity that was worshipped by the Patal of Cygnus. This entity, in reality, was a very powerful entity that was not allowed to enter into this galaxy, so it only could use its own minions, we can say, that were and are the reptilians, the Draco reptilians. So the face this entity showed was a reptilian face, as a way to disguise itself and be worshipped. Well, not only that, not only the queen began to worship that entity, but also she began to change her personality. She wanted to be alone, mostly alone. She separated herself from the rest of her family. And finally, she allowed herself to be part of a genetic experiment. So this genetic experiment was about to create a new race of beings, a blend of humanoid and draco-reptilian beings. And for that, they wanted to extract the best royal human DNA and mix it with the best royal Draco DNA. The royal Dracos are the white royal Dracos. They are whitish. They are really, really tall, maybe 6 meters, 7 meters tall, with wings. And they are very proud of themselves. So they wanted to create a new race. And the idea was that this new race had to be powerful, with a very long lifespan, and almost impossible to destroy. So they find, even for that, the queen slept or had sex in reality with her own oldest son, because, as I said, they wanted to perfect the royal human DNA. And because of that, she slept with her son. She had a baby, but in reality, the idea was only use the baby DNAs, and if it was so perfect enough, then they would use that DNA and blend it with the royal Draco DNA. Finally, they succeed. They succeed creating a new race, and this new race, we can say that is became a branch of the Anunnaki, because the Anunnaki in reality is the Anunnaki is a different kind of race, very similar races related to them, only related at this moment. At the beginning, they had a common ancestor, but little by little, they began to spread among the galaxy, and as they began to live in different planets, they adapt to the new environments, so they change. Even some mixed together with the local beings that lived on the planet. So now, at this moment, the Anunnaki in reality is a very diverse group of beings. Some more humanoid, others less. So they created a branch of humanoid. And that's why the royals, the Lyran royals or the Tal royals, had a secret agreement with the reptilians. So when they fled the Lyran wars, they fled to a different place than the other other Lyran refugees. And it was because of that. Well, so the genetic experiment took place, but meanwhile they were performing the genetic experiments, the Lyran wars took place, because at that moment the society was well infiltrated. Their egos were stronger, much stronger than before. So the consciousness, energy field around their star system had weakened enough to be invaded. So the Lyran wars broke and took place. And this was because, although the Cygnus zone of the galaxy, that part of the galaxy, was very rich in wormholes and passages to other universes, as well as rich of many different kind of minerals, interesting minerals for the reptilians, it was also very tricky, with so many X-rays sources, anomalies that moved, that they were not in only one point in space-time, but some anomalies that move, not very much, but they move enough to be unstable. And also there were also some space-time fabric distortions. Because of that, finally, the reptilians gave up on Cygnus, leaving behind destroyed civilizations and barren walls. Although They took as many minerals as they could, but they left the constellation behind. And then they focus their intentions to find other places of the galaxy more suitable for them, to find stargates that enabled them to go through the stargate and access other universes, maybe parallel universes, maybe parallel galaxies, and in this way continue their conquer. So they found that in the Lyra constellation, in the Lyra zone, there was an important stargate, because there's the Lyra nebula, the ring nebula. And the ring nebula, within it, there's a very stable stargate. So it was a very interesting place for them, because also as a nebula, it was a place that new stars were forming, new planets. So the nebula hosted many new possibilities for them. So once the Lyra wars took place, many different types of refugees fled to other worlds to establish a new world, a new home, to start anew. And among them, among of these groups, were the Patals, the traitors that came from the Cygnus constellation. And they fled. And they arrived here on the solar system and decided to land and establish on Earth. And the place on Earth that they chose was a continent that with a beautiful, a lovely vegetation, with many rivers, lakes, with a warm temperature. And this continent is what now we know it as Antarctica. And they named it Mu. So, for me, since these healing sessions took place, for me, Mu and Lemuria are not the same. They are not synonymous. In reality, although I know that many people use them as if they were the same place, the same kind of people, but for me, in reality, Mu and Lemuria are different. Similar, because they coexist during the same time, or at least part of the same time, but they were not the same, exactly the same place. Because when the Patal arrived here and established on the Mu continent, the Lemurian civilization already existed and was flourishing. So they arrived here, they established in what is now Antarctica, and they began to establish trade relationship with the Lemurians, for example. They enjoyed this place, really. But little by little, you know that Antarctica has an important stargate, or an important gate, we can say, a portal. So, finally, some female Mu colonists found or were realized about the presence of this portal, and they use only female, and they use it as a way to communicate with their god entity, and they began to worship one more time that entity. Because of that, they receive information about what to do here. So they began, at the beginning, they were only disrupting their society. They began to attract males and have sex with them. They began to disrupt families because of that. But these females had a very powerful mind, and with their mind, but they not only had a powerful mind, part of this power, or mind power, we can say, was downloaded to them through the entity. Well, so they had a powerful mind, able to penetrate, infiltrate, we can say, the male's minds, and began to manipulate them. They began to manipulate them until many males succumbed, we can say, or fell to the manipulation. They left their own families. They began to live with those females that worship the entity. They began to have orgies also, until little by little they began to worship more and more that entity. They received many downloads from that entity until they began to perform some underground experiments to create cyborgs, to create robots, mainly cyborgs and robots, but also very powerful nuclear weapons. At the beginning, it was all a secret work. Only little by little, they began to give more importance to the military until they transformed their society into a military one. So the society really was broken. Some of the Mu colonies fled to the South America continent, others to the South Africa also, and because they wanted to fled, to go away of all of the changes, until a war broke, because in reality the entity wanted the reptilians to conquer the earth, to conquer the different civilizations of the earth, conquer the earth, and from the earth conquer the entire solar system, because the earth lives, we can say, in a very particular galactic crossroads that are very interesting for the reptilians in particular. In reality, there's a crossroads that can be used for many species, but in reality the reptilians wanted to take own them, control them, because in this way they could access parallel Earths, parallel galaxies also. So, well, it was, it's in reality an important place. So, the war broke, as I said. It was really a very violent war, because they destroyed a lot, not only physical life, but also they aimed to destroy consciousness. The idea in reality was to destroy consciousness and reduce the human civilizations that were established here as mere slave, animal slave, we can say. So, well, it was really a very violent, because I perceive, we can say, many images, or yeah, we can say images of that. It was, wow, really, really bad. But as the war began, some benevolent galactic beings intervened. And in particular, for example, the feline Urma race intervened in this war. One moment. On behalf of the Syrian High Council. The Urma race are very powerful. They have honor. They are very aligned with themselves. They are very aligned with their being. So, but they are very powerful at the same time. And they manage to transform the Mu continent into an icy one. So they manage to transform the land into a huge icy land, burying below or underneath the ice the remnants of the Mu civilization. As a way to quiet all the perturbations that took place, as a way to silence the noise of the war, we can say, as a way also to help the earth to restore easily and quickly its own fabric, because it was really broken. And this war more or less ended around 1,500,000 years ago, more or less. So, and it was known as the Third Galactic War. So this is information that I wanted to share with you. And that's it for today. Have a lovely day. See you soon.